humans are storytelling creatures, and stories only go in certain ways, and many of the ways that we love stories to go, things getting better, things making sense,
are
really not the way the world works. And so I think we have imposed upon the world's messiness, the world's randomness, the world's frequent senselessness, I'm not saying it's always senseless, this hope and dream that things would be progressive, sensible, meaningful, lead to us, that is human beings, is the highest form of life. Because we have these hopes, and nature really doesn't work that way, we tend to get a lot of things wrong. I mean, this nothing, class, race, or sex, or in any of the other ways that divide us, based about natural knowledge. Now, there are all sorts of ways in which the prejudices allied to those notions influence the way we get knowledge and influence incorrect views that we have. But an eclipse of the sun is an eclipse of the sun. It is perceived by all kinds of folks, and it fascinates all kinds of folks. There's something very universalizing about science. I think that all great human achievements are potentially universalizing. I think great music and great art and great sports accomplishments are all properties. They're not achievements of a member of a particular racial group. They're achievements for all of us. There's nothing about the factual state of the universe or the history of life that is designed in order to give either solace, moral comfort, or meaning to our lives. After all, life was here for 3.5 billion years before humans ever emerged. Humans are 250,000 years old. Why should life be constructed in such a way to impart meaning to us? In fact, I think Darwin's position was very similar to that. Darwin is sometimes seen as something of a moral midget for holding similar views, but that wasn't his view. His view was that we are all, as moral agents, required as human beings to find and struggle towards moral answers for ourselves. But we're not going to find them in the factual state of nature. So if you want to think nature is perfect and that leads you to some lazy notion that maybe you can find moral meaning in nature, that's fine. Darwin's position is you might as well take a cold bath, recognize the imperfections, the uglinesses, the randomnesses, and then maybe you'll understand that you shouldn't be looking for the answer to moral questions in the factual state of nature anyway. It doesn't make sense. You need to recognize the differences in timescales. That is the fittest, in Darwin's sense, by the way, which is those that are best adapted to local conditions. After all, the morphologically degenerate parasite inside your body or our bodies is just as fit as we are to our world. So Darwinian fitness, first of all, has nothing to do with progress, but Darwinian fitness is an immediate or local concept. It doesn't accumulate over time into such patterns as increasing complexification or betterment. That is the fish in a pond, which may be a hydrodynamic marvel of perfection and may have been there for 10 million years, knocking out species after species by virtue of its perfection of design. It's still going to die if the pond dries up. So immediate local adaptations may represent a survival of the locally best fit, but the accumulation of those through time doesn't build into sensible patterns. That's where it's that translation to the larger geological timescale that engenders the lack of pattern, the randomness, the contingency, the unpredictability. It was distressing to see creationism rise so strongly in the 70s and after we beat it down in the 80s to see it still around. But I don't know that the 1990s have more irrationalism. You know, you can go back into the 1890s, which was also a great age of spiritualism, and people from Arthur Conan Doyle to Alfred Russel Wallace to the philosopher Henry Sidgwick were all into spiritualism, and good magicians like Harry Houdini were trying to show what nonsense it was. So these things vary, but they're always around, they're always powerful, and they're profoundly scary, anti-intellectual, and they need to be fought by scientists.